Good morning, dear students. Yesterday we sent the video of lesson number 9, half video of lesson number 9, in which I explained 5 programs, right? Till line rectangle statement, right? But before rectangle statement, there is one plot statement, and it was not covered in yesterday's program. Yesterday's video. So today I'm going to explain that plot statement. Plot statement is basically used to move the control to a specific location, right? Whenever we use plot statement, we will find a dot on the graphic output screen, right? We can change the color of that dot, which is a pixel basically, right? And we can change the color of that pixel also. Right now there are two dots. One is in blue color, one is in I think this is something of maroon type color, right? These are the two small pixels, small dots. I don't know you are able to see these dots or not. But let me explain the program of plot statement. CLG to clear the screen, color blue, right? Plot at point 100 on x-axis and 120 on y-axis, there is a blue pixels. It is just above the cursor point, right? Then we have color RGB 255 0 to 255, right? And at same, your x-axis is same, that is 100. Below this pixel there is another pixel here, another dot here, right? And y-axis is 150. So these are the two tiny dots, right? And when you will run this program on your system, at that time you can try to see these tiny dots, right? And then you will find out what is the use of plot statement. If we want to draw some dots on graphic output screen, in that case we can use plot statement, right? So this is plot statement. Next one is, yesterday I explained rectangle, right? Filled rectangle, one was black and another one was red, right? That rectangle was drawn using rect statement. Today I am going to explain one rectangle using line statement. Using line statement, right? So now I will draw one rectangle, but I'll not use rect statement. I'll use line statement. You can see in front of you. You have this program. CLG, clear the screen. Color red. Now, the line which we will draw will be in red color, and this is x1 y1, this is x2 y2, as I explained in line statement. Then in blue color this line, green color this line, and this is RGB value, then line and end, right? When we will run this program, you will see one rectangle like this, right? This is in red color, this is in blue color, then this is green color, and this is something of dark blue or pink, purplish shade, right? So like this we can draw rectangle, and there we have two ways, either using rect statement. In that case we will find filled rectangle. And when we will draw a rectangle using line statement, we can find this statement outline of the we can find this outline of a rectangle, right? Then is a circle. Then is a circle, right? If we want to draw a circle, this will again draw a filled circle. A filled circle, right? Now to draw a circle, the syntax is you have to write down the word circle. Then x-axis, y-axis, and this is the radius, right? Means the size of this circle is will depend on this radius. Now when we will run this program, you will find a circle. I think this is clear to you all. right? So we have not defined any color as we did in rectangle statement. Similarly here also, if I want to use some specific color, in that case we have to write, suppose color, which color, suppose blue, right? And then save the program and then yes and run, then you will find blue color circle, right? So like this we can draw a circle. And again, one more thing I want to explain, on the page number 137 there is program 9, right? In that case we have two circles, one is overlapping half circle, so we can draw two circles also. Let me show you. Color, suppose red, right? Then we have to draw a circle, right? If we talk about dimensions, so suppose x axis I'll take 150, then 150 y axis, and 50 is the radius, right? It means the size of the circle will be same, only the x axis will differ, or you can change the y axis, it depends on you, right? Let me save this program, yes, and then run the program like this, right? So we can draw 2, 3, 4, 5 as many circles as we want to draw. We just have to add the circle statement again and again for the number of circles we want to draw, right? Then we have a say statement. If we want to add sound effect in a program, in that case we have to use say statement, right? And the say statement is used to read and speak the given expression with the help of speaker of the computer. Means your speaker should be attached with your desktop, right? And here one more thing I want to tell you is, it is showing a dollar. Dollar represents string. Dollar represents string. When we want to display a string, in that case we have to write dollar here. In the program also, yesterday I explained one or two program where we that is visitors pass, well, or something, that program was there, in which we wrote name dollar, means string will be filled in that case, right? So here we have CLG, clear the graphic screen. A dollar means A is a variable in which we have saved hello friends, right? String variable. Then say means computer speaker will speak out these words loudly, and end program. Let me run the program.
Hello friends.
Yes, I think you have heard the words hello friends. Let me run it again.
Hello friends.
Yes, so this is a program when if we want to add some sound effect, we want to add something, we can use say statement. It will read out and speak the given expression. Last is sound statement, right? In sound statement, it is used to play the sound with specific amount of frequency and duration, with specific amount of frequency and duration, right? So suppose in the same we will end sound here. Let me show you sound, right? And frequency is suppose 900 and duration is 10, right? So I'll save this program, yes, and run.
Hello friends.
This shows the frequency, ki kitna frequency tells us the intensity of sound, how low or high the sound will be, right? And duration will tell you for how long you will heard the sound, right? Suppose if I'll make it 1200 and I'll make it 50 here, right? then again run the program, sorry, save the program, then run this.
Hello friends.
Right, so according to this, the sound will explain the frequency and duration, right? And your frequency is in hertz, right? And duration is in milliseconds, in milliseconds. This is all about lesson number 9, that is graphics in basic 256. This is really very interesting chapter, right? You can do as much creativity as you want to do in this chapter. Lots of practice time is there, a lot of practice questions are there. Triangle is there, they have drawn a triangle here, right? Then in one practice time they have given something, text is textile is different. So we have different activity sessions are there, so you can practice and you can show your creativity as much as you want to show, right? So students, this is all about your lesson number 9. Right, we will continue with this chapter with the exercise and question answers in the next video. For till then, you have to read this chapter very carefully and practice each and every statement very carefully. Right, you have to learn the syntax of each and every statement. So till then, stay safe, stay healthy.